Adair. Space is pretty good, dude. There's like Monster music here.
I missed Chai, actually. Chai was a lot of fun, besides the water battles were fucking awful.
But besides that, it was pretty fun. What kind of pizza is it? It's in the description, son! I even fucking wrote it there so people wouldn't ask me. Oh my god. Thanks for the host, dude. Like, you said, it says pizza. That says what it is. And it's like, what kind of pizza are you eating? I don't know, I don't really get angry over stupid shit like this, but I knew people were gonna ask like a million times, so I put it in the ticker so people wouldn't ask.
What's the matter?
Nothing. What are you doing?
Feeling another
Just
piece.
doing a piece. Get this cat out of here.
What cat?
I don't know. I hear it. Get this dog out of here. Oh yeah, I should look into OBS Studio soon. English please only. Well, I prefer you speak English because you know, not many people can talk non-English here. So, I don't know much Spanish. I only know like a handful, so I couldn't really communicate. Sorry. Fucking death. Fucking puta. Thank you. I only speak Americanese. No, I speak English. I know some Spanish, some German, very little French. Handful of like Japanese words maybe. Yeah, it was really disturbing. I guess you have like, no choice in the matter. I was looking at my YouTube stuff, so someone made a comment. And or my music stopped. He gets there. I don't know what there means. French, bonjour. salut. baguettes? I don't know. I really don't know too much French. I know people use salut a lot more than they use bonjour and many other of the kind of like basic terms. How are you? Okay. Yeah, usually, wie geht's? What? Name all the languages you know words in. Yeah, pretty much, dude. That's it's like my what do they call it? My resume. You just kind of like, oh yeah, I know all these languages. Like I know that they are languages. French is so hard. Yeah, it looks like it can be. I don't know. I've never taken French. I took some German in high school, but I dropped out of that class because fuck that. The classes I took the language class I took in high school were I took Latin, 3 years of Latin, because it was stupid because you had to take at least 1 year of Latin, regardless of whether you wanted to or not, and then 3 years of another languages, or just 2 years of one language. So I'm like, why take 4 years of a language if I could take three? Like fucking math right there, son. Why take literally a dead language at all? I don't know. Because fucking Catholic schools suck. The German accent. I mean, from my origins, I'm like part German, part Italian, part Irish, part Polish. Quite a few things going on there. Ah, okay, Maddie Fame. Yeah, I see a lot of people, French people use salut. So maybe, yeah, I guess that's like the kind of slang version. Like, yo, what's up? Salut, bitches. Tired. Did you want to play some Monster Hunter soon, Dyer? If you're still here. This used to be English. No. I think I'm HR2 now. I forgot what quests I have left, but I think I'm almost HR3. Hello, Golden Experience. Goodbye, Golden Experience. Oops. Yeah, mods are unaffected by emote only. Sure, you streamed like 2 days. Fuck. I mean, pizza's pretty mediocre, but I mean, it's Pizza Hut, so it's kind of, it is what it is. Here's the rest of the pizza. Close to my mouth. I could zoom in, I guess, but I don't know. I really don't see the bit. Is it raining? I don't think so. Last I checked, it wasn't. Feud review. Payback ribs. I don't really like ribs, honestly, all that much. It's like so-so. Am I doing with my life? I don't know, dude. It's kind of what I'm trying to figure out right now. Too late for pizza. That sucks, dude. Yeah, I got it like right before they closed. It's kind of a shame. I felt bad because, like, I think last time I went to, well, I don't know if it was last time. One of these times I went, like, their website said they closed at, like, X time. I forgot what time it was, so I'm just using X. And I came in, like, at that time, like, a little bit before. And it's like, they're all like, ready to go. I'm like, oh. It's like, yeah, we actually closed at like, you know, half an hour ago or 15 minutes ago. I'm like, oh, well, shit. Like, I didn't know that. Like, you guys need to fix your times on your website, dude. My time's not bad. Most other places around here close at like 9. It sucks. If you ever want food like after 9, you're usually fucked. There's like a Sheetz. And, I don't know. Random pictures of Vinny. I don't think either of us would really appreciate that, but sure. Unfortunately, not stalker enough. I know that there's like a few people who have this like... They have like a shrine of Vinny, where they just have like... any picture he's ever taken or shown. It's kind of weird. That one picture of turtles, or what was it? There was like a GIF or something like Snake Billy's friend made, or it had like you, what was it, turtles? There was like that one picture, like Snake Billy's friend made. It was like a turtles, like an actual turtles, but it had like your face on it. It was like so weird, and you're like crying. I know, like, Gambit was there too, or some shit. That was hilarious. Oh, Buddy's friend. Oh, okay.
That picture, dude, that was hilarious.
Game is hard, dude. Alright, I'll play more Moga Village, because this one's good. I need more lemonades. I don't feel like getting upstairs, though. Not on. Oh, maybe Snake really had it. I guess not. Fucking Snake Billy. I heard Madsen was playing Dota again recently. I missed out. I've been trying to do like the quest solo, but it's so fucking painful. Like the regular quests aren't bad, but it's like the one quest I have to do for Dota 2 where it's like deward 7 times, and then like everyone on both teams doesn't pick support. So it's like, oh boy, until I get to deward all these wards that don't fucking exist. Or even one earlier where I was about to deward it and it like disappeared right as I get the last hit in. I'm like, oh thanks, Obama. Fucking asshole. Or they all have like other idiots around you like deward when you're trying to deward it. Or like just take it when you. They'll take the ward, like they'll deward it while you like put all the sentries and shit down because they're assholes. That's like the worst quest. Honestly, I even played a Zeus and it just does not help. Fucking Zeus, man. Fucking Zeus. Hey, friend, what's up? Thank you. This shirt was given to me by Hootie. I remember he sent it to me, and like, who sent me a shirt? I like, I had no idea, I was so confused. And then, it really does, because then it's like you focus so much on the quest, it's like you don't care about winning or anything anymore. Donatos? I don't know what that is. But like the observer one is like it's like pretty much like RNG. There's no you have no control. Like unless you like rush a gem or something, but even then it's like I don't know, dude. It's fucking stupid. Cause there's no guarantee that like other people are going to like there's no guarantee other people are gonna put down wards. It's so fucking dumb. I hate that quest. Balsamic glaze, there's just like a glaze on it. It's like brown. Balsamic. Triggered Ethan face, yeah. See the brown shit on there? It's balsamic glaze. Papa Bless. I heard that, I heard in the Ghostbusters movie there's some Papa in there. Get a little Papa Bless in there. God, I watched, Half in the Bag with that. And they gave a pretty solid thing. I mean, it was 45 minutes, so they're obviously pretty thorough. I don't know. It just seems so bad, that movie. On like every level. But whatever. Chain pizza. Well, you gotta get your product placement in there, son. It's like they described it pretty much. It's like it's like a fucking Adam Sandler movie. It really is, like from what I could tell. It was like literally like pixels. It was painful. Gotta get your Cokes, your Papa John's, your what was there something else in that movie? Oh, Pringles. Enjoying the pizza, for the most part. I don't really remember the original, very well, but Ghostbusters 2 is definitely one of my favorite movies. Pixels is a masterpiece? Well, I guess it depends on your definition of masterpiece. If you would think that a steaming pile of shit is a masterpiece, then yeah, I guess that would count. I don't know. I still haven't seen either of those, but I could tell just from like everything. It's not a movie I would enjoy by any means. I mean, just the characters alone. Like, the only redeeming factor to Pixels is it has fucking Tyrion Lannister, aka Peter Dinklage, in there. Yeah, you only need to do Ward 3, but Turtles 2. So, like, when you have the quest thing, like the whatever, pass and shit, when you get all the way to the end, you get this skin. But if you want the alternative skin, you need to do all the quests, every single one, and you have to 3-star all of them. Otherwise, fuck you. Which is stupid. So if you get 3 stars, then it's like, you know, you have to get 7, which is not that bad either. But then again, it depends on if the other team wants to fucking ward, and if the other team picks all fucking carries, and your fucking team all picks carries. Is there any consolation that all the skins are awful? Yeah, they are. I like the Kling skin. I think that one's okay. It's nothing super amazing, but I've been watching. Like, I saw that they had like the legendary skins or whatever, like the competition where the bracket. I wish that Jakiro was still in there. I love Jakiro, but he's gotten, like, no love, dude. Like, just give him some fucking skin. I don't care. Jakiro's so cool, dude. I think it's dumb that a lot of, like, heroes just don't have any skins whatsoever. Like, I understand, like, yeah, humans are much easier to make skins than, like, a fucking, like, flying snake man or something, or dragon man. But, yeah, I don't know. Like, fucking, I'd just like to see some legendary skins, dude. Like they did with Nyx. They give Nyx like a million skins. Wisp Arcana? Oh my god. Dude, that's like a troll though, dude. That's no way. Well, yeah, I mean, I think Invoker has like a million skins, so like fucking Invoker. But like fucking Wisp, dude? Like no one even used Wisp, dude. He's so garbage. Like, yeah, he can be okay occasionally, but like he's definitely. Like, I don't know, dude. Just like give Wisp like a. When I was memeing. Just, like, give him, like, an alternative skin color. Just, like, make him, like, instead of, like, a light blowing ball, make him, like, a red or green blowing ball or some shit. Something stupid, like the, what is it, the Shadow, not the Shadow Demon, the Terror Blade skins. I don't know, dude. Also, yeah, I can understand why people are getting frustrated with, like, Pokemon Go people, like, walking around at night. Like, if you're gonna walk around in Pokemon Go at night, like, if you're gonna be, like, near the street and shit, like, wear some fucking reflective gear. Because I was driving to get this pizza, and, like, people, like, walking, like, paying attention, like, fucking walking in the middle of the street, and, like, dude, like, I'm gonna run you over. I can't fucking see you, dude. Like, holy shit. The only thing you'll be catching is my fucking grill, dude. Awful layouts. Well, Pokemon Go is pretty, like, difficult to set up from what I could tell. So, I don't know. First Pokemon Go murder. There probably has been murders and other shit. I think a lot of the stories, like, on the news, I don't know. I think a lot of the stories in the news and shit, like, or, like, the fake news, like, it is fake. I know there's been things like robberies, which I think is real. I can see that. But I think a lot of some of the like, more severe stuff has just been like, oh, you know, hey, Lamal, this is so funny. It's like fake news, but it's not real news. Favorite top 3 fucking movies? That's a good question. I'd probably put like Office Space, Super Troopers. I don't know, I'm trying to think what else. I know there's one thing where the guy, like, supposedly found a murderer, which I guess is up in the air if it's fake or not. You boys like Mexico? Super Trooper is one of my, like, huge all-time favorites. It's just a hilarious movie. Same with Office Space. Well, Super Troopers is just fucking so good. Beer Fest, I thought, was pretty okay, like in comparison. There's also a lot of funny shit from that, but I think Super Troopers is just a classic. There's the Allspace all the way through. Allspace is hilarious. Like, even if you never really worked an office job, like, I think there's a lot of things you can kind of relate to if you worked any kind of job. A third one, I don't know. That's a tough one. Like, sometimes I like some of those, like, deeper movies, like, V for Vendetta and, like, The Matrix and some of the shit, but I wouldn't really say they're, like, my top, I'm just trying to take a look over in my movie section. I don't know. I can't really give you a third one, honestly. It's tough. Mina 911. I don't, that wasn't really. Did they make a movie of that? I did watch that show. I found it funny. Inception, best movie. I never watched Inception. Night Deployment is a cutie pie. That's definitely true. Yeah, I mean, from what I understand from Inception, like, it was, like, praised as the best movie ever. It seems, kind of overrated, from what I can tell, to some extent. Like, it's good, but not, like, the best thing ever. So, I don't know. I never finished watching the Batman series either, and I think they're both made by Legendary Films or some shit, I don't know. I watched Batman 1 and 2 or whatever, Batman Begins, Batman Beyond, or Beyond, shit, Batman Beyond. I think they made a movie of that too, but I don't know. I remember there was like one where Batman Beyond, where like the Robin becomes the Joker or some shit. That was pretty crazy. Doesn't want Space Odyssey. Rambo. I like the Rocky movies a good bit. I like a lot of comedy stuff. I like a lot of the older comedy. I guess like all the new comedy, all it is like it like it's just fucking like parties and shit. And it's not funny, dude. Like it's so cliche at this point. It's just like disgusting. It's like, all right, bros. Let's make a movie, bro. Bruh. Okay, bruh. Let's do this shit, bruh. Okay, bruh. Let's do this. We're gonna fucking film it in a party. Yeah, bruh. Totally, dude. It's gonna be crazy shit, man. I don't know. It's just like every fucking movie is like some fucking like party movie. And it's just like, I don't know, dude. It's just not funny anymore, bro. Like, at least be creative. Like, fucking Ghostbusters, like, 2 and 1 were creative. Like, you had, like, a bunch of fucking nerds who, like, dropped out of college or whatever, and then they, like, came Ghostbusters. And it was funny. And, they had, like, some gags and shit. I don't know. It's hard to find, like I said, it's hard to find good comedy. I talked about this the other day. Oversaturation, stoner flicks, yeah. Like the whole Pineapple Express, I had no idea what the fuck that was. I never saw it. But I know it was pretty much about like huge stoner flicks. Where is Tales of Vesperia movie? Well, I cried like multiple times during it last we stream when we were watching it the other day. I don't know, it's really good. I think for an anime a adaptation of a game, I think that was like a really solid movie. Did I actually cry? Yes. I don't like ball cry. It's kind of like when, men cry and just like tears kind of go down their face. Like at the end of Metal Gear Solid 3, where he's just like saluting and tear goes down. I don't know, but no, that movie was quite good and sad at many parts. But again, I think for an anime adaptation of a game, that was really, really solid. And like the voice actors and everything were good too. Like they brought the two main characters' voice actors from the game into the movie, which is like a huge plus. Because a lot of times it's like you have like a movie or something, or and it's just like none of the same voice actors at all, and it's like, it doesn't do it. It's like it's, you know, it ruins your experience because it's like, well, it's all English anyway, so it's like, why not have the same voice actors, you know? Not all the voice actors were the same, but it was fine because the two main voice actors were the same, and those were the two main characters of the movie because it was a prequel anyway. So the other characters that weren't the same voice actors were, you know, they're kind of just like, oh, like I know that character, but it wasn't like, oh, well, these people are a main part of the story. But they're not, because you don't see them until later in the story anyway, so it wouldn't make sense that they'd be like a huge part of the story. So and they play minor roles, so it's like whatever, dude. Why even bother? So I don't know. I think with the Hangover and movies like that are kind of meh. Mob Psycho, I've heard a lot about it. I'm definitely gonna look into it, Fran. That's Mob Psycho's the One Punch Man, like maybe the same people made One Punch Man or something like that. Is this anime is pretty good? I don't know. The Hangover movies, I mean, I don't like Zach Galifianakis or whatever the fuck his name is. I think he's like one of those people who just tries too hard to be funny and just ends up looking like a huge jackass in the long run. Like, except with him and like Jack Black and Michael Cera, they get typecasted where they just like, they are typecasted in this like specific. Like whatever it is. Galifianakis. Wasn't that Galifianakis, the fucking guy in Super Troopers? I don't know, Super Troopers again, it's a very clever, funny movie. Like every part of it. But it's just like Zach gets typecasted as like this fat bumbling idiot. Like Jack Black, same deal, fat bumbling idiot, except that he like makes dick and fart jokes, like fucking like 8-year-old jokes, like every movie he's ever done. And then you have like Michael Cera, who's just like a fucking pussy in every single movie, and it's just like, oh, Michael Cera, please, could you like go out with me or something, dude? You know, I don't know, dude. Yeah, I think he was. I heard he was good in Arrested Development, but like every movie he's been in, he's been typecasted sadly after that, so. Yeah, there was a few things. There was King Kong. There was one movie. I think it was like Will Smith is like on the run from the FBI or something like that. Or they, I forgot. What was that? Someone knows that movie. I think Will Smith's like on the run from the FBI. There's like a weird conspiracy going on, and they like lock him out of all his bank accounts and shit. Like, I think in that movie, he played a minor role. He was just like some hacker dude. Or some shit like that. I mean, the state, I think that was it, yeah. I guess in like King Kong. I know that was like a really like big movie, but I don't know. I mean, it had Steven Spielberg's name on it, but like I've tried to watch it. I own it, and it's just like, you know, it's okay. Like it's not really like a movie that like interests me, you know. Like I watch it, and it's like okay, I get the plot, but it's not like, I don't know, dude. It's not really doing it for me, you know? So, it's whatever. What shows I watch? I don't really watch many shows, actually. I mean, like I said, I honestly have been just catching like random animes and shit lately, but I don't know. I'm not really big on shows. Like I can't keep up with shit. Like people are like how have you not watched like fucking 50 hours of Game of Thrones? Like I don't know, 'cause it's a lot of fucking time. I don't have, dude. Like I watched season one of Game of Thrones, like they're like 6 seasons now or something like that, and like each episode is an hour, and each season's like 10 episodes or something like that. So it's like I'm literally behind like 40, 50 hours. So it's like yeah, I don't know, dude. Like. It's just like, I mean, it looks really good. The other problem is that everyone fucking spoils it to oblivion. Like it's so fucking pointless to watch it when you can just watch Twitter ruin it for you. Like it's like I don't understand what people do, like these commentaries on Twitter. Like they like describe like everything that happens either during like a show or a stream. I think streaming is like one of the worst things. It's like they describe every second like of something that happens on someone else's stream. It's like, okay, dude, like I get it. Like you're watching that person's stream, like fuck. But like same thing with fucking Game of Thrones, where it's like, oh, you know, Hodor and other shit. It's like, oh boy, dude. Yeah, live tweeting, like some things it can be acceptable, but most things it's really dumb. At least there's things like people either want to enjoy for themselves or just don't care or have any interest. So it's like. I don't know, dude. I just don't get it. Using Twitter for Twitter? Well, it's like annoying when you use Twitter and you like ruin things for other people. It's kind of like. Then you just unfollow them and that solves that problem, but it's like hard to do that with like everyone, you know? I guess you could if you really wanted to, but Eric and Andre, I don't know. I've watched maybe one. It seemed like one of those really wacky shows that didn't make any fucking sense. It was like, I don't know. Again, I watched like one episode. It just seemed for less people. Yeah, I've tried that, and then I get in Schitt's Creek for it. Like, oh, why'd you unfollow me? I fucking you hate me, don't you? And it's like, no. I don't know. That's the problem is like when you follow someone, you go into like that like personal like engagement where it's like I don't know what you want to call it. Oh, it's like a unwritten contract. Where it's like if you follow this person, you are like bound to them for the rest of eternity. And if you unfollow them, like you hate them and you want them to die or something. It's like what the fuck no. That's like not how it works. Sometimes I just unfollow people because I don't want to see all this shit. It's nothing personal, mate. You can still be my friend and all that. I just don't always want to see all the stuff you post. It's that simple. Yeah, I know you can just mute people, and like that's always an option, but then it's like, well, what if you mute someone and they like tweet at you? And then it's like, wow, why is Fred ignoring me? What a dick. When it's just like, I'm following him, like. I don't really know how muting works. I think a lot of the system with Twitter is really odd of how it works. Like, it doesn't work like half the time. Or it doesn't work ideally. So it's like if you don't want to see some of like certain people's tweets and shit, like I guess you can mute them, but well, you get emails. I don't get emails anytime everyone tweets me, though. That's the thing. I don't know, there's like a lot of issues. So like you can like mute someone or whatever, but you'll still see like retweets of their shit, like versus other like if other people retweet it. What's up, JP? I like United, though sadly my sub can only last forever with them. As in, I don't think I'll be subbing to them again anytime soon until I get like actual money. Twitter's owned by morons. Yeah, I guess I don't know. I like Twitter quite a bit, but I don't know. It just some of those things are kind of counterintuitive slash productive, so. I don't know. Like, I guess if you just block someone, you cannot see their tweets at all. But, like, that's the thing. Like, certain times I just don't want to see, like, all the shit people tweet. But it's not like I just want to block them, you know? So, it's like I want to leave the communication there open, but it's just like I don't want to see all the shit that they post. Whether it be retweeted or not. So, it is what it is. I don't like the idea of muting people. It just doesn't work the way you want it to, so. Who knows? I need to get more lemonade. Looks a bit like Rev. I don't think so, but sure. I think Rev has a thinner face than I do. Randall. Oh yeah, that's actually another great movie. Fucking Clerks and Clerks 2. Clerks 2 is fucking hilarious. I love Clerks 2. It was one of my favorite movies. I don't see the Jack Black thing either, honestly. Like, again, I don't know, dude. I don't see it. I'd be like another 60 pounds. And just have like a meme face. Shrimp pizza. That sounds so weird. Girlfriend sucked 37 dicks in a row. I don't really remember Clerks 1 all that much, but Clerks 2 was like another one of those movies. Like the sequel was fantastic. I haven't seen a lot of the other movies though, like Chasing Amy and like Dogma and other stuff like that, so. Put them together. I mean, I like shrimp. I don't know how I don't know how I think would shrimp with cheese. I don't know, dude. Show the pizza. I will in a minute. Let me go get more lemonade here. Berserker. Another the thing of doing another Clerks, but I feel at this point like a Clerks 3, I don't know, it just seems like it would be like a Zoolander 2 kind of thing where it's like in like a what was the other movie that was like really long delayed? It was like another classic movie. It was like the kind of like the Death Note in real life where like the people are just kind of like vigilantes. Boondock Saints. Yeah. Like, the Boondock Saints 2 came out like so much later. It's just like, why? I don't know. Like, a lot of these movies, I just feel come out too late where they're relevant anymore. That's why it's like good that there wasn't a Ghostbusters 3, because like, well, Ghostbusters 3 would have been amazing, but not like now, because it's like, the fuck. Fucking prunes. That was a good movie too. Was it something eight or something? The one with like the fucking prunes. What was it called? Like Sector 8 or something? Sting 2? I don't remember. Oh, District 9. Okay, that's right. There you go. Sector 8, District 9. Like, Sector 8's like the fucking bootleg version. District 9, that's what it was. Thank you. I thought that was an interesting movie. It was a weird one, but it was pretty good. All right, let me go get more lemonade. I'll give you some more Mocha Village because it's good shit. I'll be right back. The Happening? Oh my god. The Happening, I think, is probably like the worst movie I've ever seen. Possibly. Like, it was one of the worst movies I've ever seen, like, in a theater. Like, it just was so stupid, dude. Like, I don't understand. Like, if you compare that movie to, like, a movie like The Mist, right? The Mist was actually, like, interesting, but it was, like, scary and, like, mysterious. Where The Happening was just, like, people dying for no reason, like, stupid shit, like, a weird, like, scene with, like, the wife. He's like, oh, you were horny. It's like, what the fuck? I don't know, dude, that was so bad. It was just so bad. I just couldn't understand it. Like, it didn't make ending, like, make any sense. The ending of Mist, yeah. It's pretty sad. But you can kind of compare the two movies as being, like, mysterious things killing people to some extent. But, like, The Mist, you at least get some idea of, like, what's killing them, like, some weird things in the mist. While it's, like, The Happening is, like, not happening for any reason whatsoever. What do I feel about The Thing? Is The Thing, what do you mean? Which thing? Like The Thing, like from Fantastic Four, or like the Changeling thing, or I don't know. I don't think I've seen it either way. But Kurt Russell, one with huskies in it. Son of a Mask. Oh my God. I don't know. I don't think I've seen the thing, so I couldn't tell you. The Son of Mask. I don't know. I really actually liked The Mask back in the day, like a classic Jim Carrey movie. I thought it was pretty funny. I have no idea how well it's aged, but Son of Mask. It was. I don't know when that movie took place, but it was literally like, and again, another one of those movies where it's like we need like a few extra bucks. You know, Mask did really well. Even this movie like is like fucking $5 budget, we'll still make like off box office bank because it'll win, you know, make money on name alone. Like what was that one fucking awful Adam Sandler movie? What was it called? The one where he plays his own sister. Something Jill. All of them. To be fair, a lot of old Adam Sandler movies were Jack and Jill. Okay. I thought it was Jack and Jill. I didn't know it was that simple. But I guess I should expect as much from Adam Sandler. But oh my God, like it was another movie where it was just like an awful idea, awful concept, awful everything. Then it's like, you know, still make a shit ton of money just because, you know, Adam Sandler. A lot of his classic movies were kind of funny, you know, for the day. There was one that actually wasn't too bad. It was like a Disney one where he was like at the hotel. Like the concept of that movie was all right. Like, you know, they did like a decent job with it. Do over. I haven't seen Click or Do Over or whatever. Bedtime Stories. That one was okay. It wasn't like obnoxious. It wasn't like, you know, Adam Sandler obnoxious. I mean, it was Disney, so There was so only so much he could really do there, anyways. But I don't know. I like the Colonel Sanders looking motherfucker in Bedtime Stories. Click is doesn't go over the top. Really? I remember the whole thing with Click, like the trailer was like the lady like moving like running and he like slows it down so you can see like boobs like fucking bouncing and shit. Maybe that was just a trailer, I don't know, but Nicolas Cage, that's a good question. Now, as I was watching Astro Boy, Nicolas Cage was in that recently. Bedtime Stories, I guess the what it was about was like he's like, of course, it's the thing where it's like he comes a loser. His dad owns this hotel. Colonel Sanders buys the hotel from the dad because they fall on hard times. Like the Colonel Sanders guy like makes the hotel into like a super hotel. But like the Colonel Sanders guy is like, well, at least I promised your son he'll become like hotel manager when he gets older. But of course, it never happens, and then it's like, they try to make it happen. I guess like the daughter, or the daughter being Adam Sandler's sister in the movie, they have like rough time at home, but she has two kids, and he has to take care of the two kids. And I guess they have some like thing where he tells them like these stories, the bedtime stories, and they become like real, or something like that. So like they happen in real life. Con Air, I thought was pretty funny and interesting. I don't know, I like that movie. Fucking John Malkovich, Nicolas Cage, and then he had Steve Buscemi. I'm trying to think who else was in that movie. Con Air is a meme? Yeah, I believe that. I think it's one of those like weird movies. I'm broadcasting from space, yes. God. Is my cup size? I don't know, dude. Probably like what's the smallest cup size? Very flat chested, dude. Wicker Man is also a meme. Wicker Man's always been a meme, dude. Hey. Yeah. I'd be an A. I'd be like one of those like girls in high school that wear like the have like the bra padding, whatever you want to call it. My cup size, they actually met like for like cock cups. Do they like measure those? I think there really isn't need to. It's like, unless for some reason you're fucking like hard on when you're playing football or something, which is pretty weird. Like, why are you getting so fucking like horny when you're playing like a sport? I wouldn't see why you need like multiple sizes for that. So yeah, so many people get confused what I'm talking about. So there's like, they call it a cup. And it's like a plastic thing you put over your dong. So, like, if people, like, if you're playing sports or something like that, if for some reason you get knocked in the dong, like, you're solid. Like, you're not gonna be injured. It's very useful in football. Imagine baseball and other things that would be useful as well. Like, someone throws a fucking baseball at your cock, you're protected. Shit happens, especially when you're playing soccer and so too, where you're just kind of running around and, suddenly you get fucking nailed. I remember I was playing basketball one day, and I was like dribbling the basketball like at an angle. It was just dribbling basketball, and there was like a thing like where the balls are stored at an angle. There the like. There was like an incline, and I was dribbling, and like I bounced off the incline and bounced back and fucking nailed me, and that shit hurt. That was not pleasant. And get Pizza Hut. What should I get it on it? I don't know, dude. Whatever you want. I usually get a medium pizza that has like three toppings. Yeah, I mean, lessens the impact, it still hurts. Well, I mean, it's gonna push against your torso versus like hitting you in the balls or something like that, which is a lot more sensitive. They already ordered pizza. You can get Pizza Hut usually has like Oh, I mean, what is a cup size? I don't know. It's like fucking huge, dude. It doesn't. It's like not measured in liters, mate. I don't fucking know. It's probably like, I don't know, 3 liters, 4 cups, 2 nanoliters or something. I don't know. Footlongs. I don't know, but pizza usually has like a medium pizza deal where you can get like three topping pizza for like $6. So it's not bad. 1 cup, yeah. This is one yellow mug size. This is the American unit of measurement. One yellow mug. One mug, man. How big is my ass? I don't know, I'm pretty decent sized ass. It was like one of those weird things I actually got complimented on in high school. So you got like a nice ass. I'm like, oh, thanks, I guess. Like, what the fuck? Again, considering I went to Catholic school, that was very odd. Yellow is the biggest color, yeah. Yeah, you can get like a medium one topping and you buy two, but I don't know. I'm sure there's a lot of economical ways you can approach buying your pizza. I know they have like this like 2 foot long pizza now. It looks weird. I'd probably try it though. No one delivers. Feels bad, man. The shadow makes it look like I have super big eyebrows. It's so weird. Where my sunglasses at? I ate the food, dude. I'm full. Almost 7K. Yeah, getting close. I'm digesting. Yeah. What's my name? My name is Fred, dude. Social digestion, yeah. I have like 8 stomachs. I'm like a fucking sheep. Sheeple. Do I like deep dish? Deep dish is okay. I prefer New York style. But I don't know. It's I don't have the opportunity to have deep dish very often. So it's like, oh, you know, it's like, oh, well, deep dish just sucks. I'm like, well, what deep dish do you have? It's like Uno's. Like Uno's is fucking like a chain restaurant, dude. It's not even like a real like pizza place. It'd be the same as like, wow, you know, regular style pizza sucks. So it's like, well, what are your options? Pizza Hut? Well, no shit, dude. The pizza you have is garbage. Like, of course it's not gonna be good. So it's like, I don't know. It's hard to, like, make a judgment on deep dish. I think some deep dish could be really good slash interesting. I prefer to have, like, some of their weirder style pizzas. So, like, I don't know, like it's like spinach artichoke kind of thing or something like that. Like those, I tend to be, I think, more interesting to me versus like just like a regular pepperoni deep dish. Little Caesars. Little Caesars is probably one of the worst pizza places. Like, I eat a lot of garbage pizza, like Pizza Hut, but Little Caesars is like top of the list there. Pizza was okay. I'm full actually. I have like, I'm like halfway through a slice. I hate being that guy, but it's my fucking pizza, so I really don't care. I don't know how people like Little Caesars, dude. It's so bad. Yeah, it's like probably one of the cheapest pizzas you can get, but it really is awful. Like I can eat, like I said, a lot of garbage pizza, but I have a hard time like finishing like Little Caesars. Oftentimes, like, if I don't finish it, I want to throw it away because it's that gross. Like, it's not something I want to eat later. It's like one of those desperation pizzas. Poor doesn't make it good, dude. I mean, I eat a lot of cheap shit too. It doesn't make it good. What's up, Deska? I need to get ready for the charity event by whatever it is. The Gravity Rush 2 looks good. Did Shuhai recover his Twitter account? I guess he did because he retweeted some stuff. Yeah, he's been tweeting all day. Okay. Yeah, some fucking jackass like hacked him. I'm like, really, dude? It's like, we're not a hacking group. Like, go fuck yourselves. Socially for charity now. Oh, the Sunland pizzas are even worse than Little Caesars, dude. It's, again, just like desperation pizza. Papa John's does need to lower its prices. Papa John's is like garbage. It's like it's again fast food pizza, so it's like okay food-ish, but like I like Papa John's every once in a while. Like I'll get Papa Bless if I need to, but like the prices for a Papa John's pizza, it's like you can buy a real pizza for the same fucking price. So it's like why would I buy it at Papa John's? Like $16 for like a large pizza. Like fuck that. I can go to like a real pizza place, like, you know, like authentic Italian pizza place, and get the same fucking thing for cheaper or the same price. So it's like, why would you go to Papa John's? It's fucking stupid. Do I have a job? Not at the moment, no. I'm currently full-time streaming. When you're drunk and desperate, that's what was when we had PAX East. We were drunk and desperate. I ordered some Domino's because like the only place open at like 1 a.m. for delivery. And what was it? Oh, the fuckers! There's two entrances to like the hotel on each side. And I thought he was just gonna bring it to my room because he asked for my room number, like what my room number is this. But like I kept getting calls, like we're not gonna give you the pizza if you don't come and get it. Like I was sitting at the front door, I'm like, where the fuck are you guys? And then you ended up going in the back way. I'm like, what the fuck, dude? And he's like, all right, whatever. But it was just frustrating as hell. But the pizza was decent for being drunk out of our ass. Do I check the brewery? Not really. Very rarely. Because I don't get art very often, so I have no real reason to check very often. I mean, if you make art, I will check it out if it's reasonable. If you like Photoshop some shit, then I'm not really that interested. Unless you do something pretty hilarious, but most of the time it's not. I often check Twitter more likely than anything, and then Twitter's like it's a win-win because like I get to check it out on my Twitter, and then like I could always retweet it and then stuff. You get all those favorites, get that social popularity points, easy. Yeah, usually Papa John's is okay if you get like a good coupon, but I never pay full price for Papa John's. Just fuck that. Star Trek Beyond World premiere is happening outside my house, and I'm inside watching. Okay, thank you, Wakuzu. Yeah, you go to Papa John's for the memes, of course, of course. Pay to eat pizza. No, well, kind of. I mean, most of my, well, every, oh, not most of it, all of it pretty much is from you guys. Anything I get or make is from either subs or donations at the moment. In the small amount of ad revenue, I guess I make, but I don't even really queue ads, so it's like whatever. But yeah, I mean, subs definitely help out quite a bit. I'm slowly inching back up there. Like that's the thing with subs, like as I know Bakwa was saying this earlier too, where it's like, oh, you get like a bunch of subs. I'm like, well, yes and no. It's like I'll get a bunch of subs, but then I'll have a lot of people unsub too. So it's like right now I'm at 73 out of 100 before I get some more emotes. Which is good. So we're getting there, like 27 away from 100, which is pretty cool. But people on sub and then it's like real rip, the dream. So, but it's all good. I understand people have can only afford for certain weeks or months or whatever. I mean, I've had to unsub to some people I've been sub to forever as well. So it kind of sucks, but it is what it is. Homemade pizza with tortilla? Like a Mexican pizza or something? Could you check a thing? Sure, I guess. I mean, I'm not gonna show someone else's thing. Like, I've had that before too, where someone's like, oh, did you see this picture I did of Vinny on the Buru? Or, something like that? And it's like, no. Like, why would I naturally look? I'm like, yeah, I guess I'm slightly on the narcissistic side, but, like, I don't know. Like, the majority of the Buru is, Vinny and Joel, which is cool. Like, more power to them. But in reality, like, I don't, for one, again, I don't check the Buru, like, very often at all. And secondly, it's like, I don't really. Like, it'd be like, oh, did you see, like, the Mona Lisa I painted for Da Vinci? Like, no. Like, I don't, you did it for him, like, not for me. Like, I don't really care all that much. It's cool and everything. Like, I'm sure it's a great job, but like, I usually not gonna like. I usually don't like go out of my way to see what everyone else or everything else is going on in the world, you know? So. Then they queue up a lad ad. Yeah, I mean, zero. I don't know, like most of the time, like lately, especially because I've been streaming a lot of RPGs, like I don't get like a ton of viewers. Like I think it's worth queuing up an ad if it's like if you have 100 viewers or more, but like my numbers haven't been amazing, so like right now it's pretty nice, but I guess between like, especially because now I have the I think my subs are immune to ads. I haven't checked. I think that subs are opt out of ads. If you're a turbo user, I'd definitely recommend whitelisting Twitch. So I know some people were like that, where they're like, "Oh, I have ad block," but like, you're a fucking turbo user, dude. I don't know if it really makes a difference either way, but it would be better on the safe side just to have the turbo. If you're a turbo user, have you know if you could use ad block, have it off. Yeah, I know that feel, Nefkin. I know my sister's boyfriend wants me to play WoW. I'm like, I don't have the money for this, dude. Like, I don't want to spend for fucking that shit. Yeah, I think yeah, you still get ads on mobile. Really, that's weird. Abortion Shark. When I had Turbo, I never get ads on mobile. So I don't know. That's weird. Try and hold back the tears? I'm not sure. My nose is really itchy because of allergies. But yeah, I mean, I think, like, if I just, like, queue ads all the time when I have, like, low viewers, it's definitely not worth it. Copy of WoW. I have, like, multiple copies of WoW up until, like, I guess the current expansion or something like that. Because they want me to come back desperately, so they'll send me, like, free time and, like, upgrades and shit all the time, but it's like, yeah, I don't know. Yeah, and speaking of ads, so like I said, I think I was mentioning this earlier. I don't know if I finished my story, but yeah, there's like fucking Trump ads on YouTube. Like, I went to my own YouTube page, I got like a Trump ad. I'm like, what the fuck, dude? Like, obviously, I don't think I have a choice in the matter of which ads are broadcast on my videos, but it's like, really? Like, no, thank you. Like, please, no. I don't want people thinking like I'm endorsing him. Like, what the fuck? Or like, Trump, where's my cash money, dude? Where's that millions of dollars? Better fucking fork that shit under the table, mate. I'll put your fucking ads on my YouTube videos. Fucking sell out. Trump, too. But no, I don't know. I think that's weird. I guess that's kind of expected. I remember it was like the whole thing with the guy with the knowledge. Sellout confirmed. Hell yeah, dude. Facebook is financially backing Trump. I believe it. Know. I'd rather not talk about Trump. I just thought it was weird that they had those ads on there that I definitely don't want. Like, you put Call of Duty ads, whatever, all day, I don't care. But like that kind of ads, like, no, thank you. So I don't want people to think I politically would support someone that I don't want to. Fred for president, yeah. Silent Hill dog ending. I don't think I've seen that. I don't know, maybe I have. I know Bach does a lot of the endings for that, but I usually don't really, I don't really like Silent Hill all that much. This is a Blue Yeti microphone, yes. Integrated? Yeah, Blue Yeti is really good. I mean, you can get the Blue Yeti. There's like the Blue Yeti Snowball, the whatever this one is, and then there's like the Pro. This one's like kind of like the go-to one for streamers. I'd love to have like a mixer. And, fucking hair. I really love to have a mixer and like another microphone, but I really don't know enough about that kind of stuff. I could probably ask in like the Discord. Like, there's a partners Discord. Like, there's a Discord for partners. Do I listen to any rap? You know, Drake all day, son. No, I don't really listen to rap very often, if ever. At least I don't go out of my way to listen to it most of the time. I don't know. I don't really listen to a ton of music in general, though. The most recent music I listened to was actually Vinny's album, which I do like quite a bit. I know, I feel kind of bad because it's like, well, he gave me the album at PAX, and I just listened to it now. But again, I don't have a CD player. It's a CD. So it's like, I don't know how I'm going to listen to this. I don't know, with an album too, I kind of want to sit down and listen to it, like, you know, pretty thoroughly. I feel you can't really appreciate listening to music if you just hear it like once, or at least with some music. A CD, yeah, I know. But no, I don't know. Shitty iTunes, yeah, I don't use iTunes either. But yeah, no, he released it on YouTube, like the full album, so I listened to it there. I'm not sure if I want to take it out of the case or not yet. As a kind of, as a collector, I kind of like things like fairly pristine if I don't really intend to use it often or something to that effect. So I don't know, maybe I'll have some collector's value one day, who knows. But either way, even if it did, it's more of a kind of like a sentimental thing, you know? Even if it did like gain value, I don't think it's something I would give away because, like, you know, this is music my friend made and I appreciate that, so. iTunes to Skype and music. Yeah, iTunes is pretty fucking awful, but so is anything Apple related, so it's kind of expected. The Beatles. I listen to some of the Beatles. I'm not, like, huge on the Beatles. Zoom Master Race, yeah. Zoom, I don't know. They're okay. I don't think they're, like, as super amazing, like, the best band ever. But, I don't know. I think with the Beatles, like, they have, like, a lot of, like, history and, like, story to them that I think makes them a bit more interesting. Then like the actual music really kind of makes them out to be, if that makes sense. So it's like more of the story and like the personality and stuff with the Beatles kind of makes them, like, I feel makes them a bit more of who they are versus like their music alone. Maybe it's a mix of both. I don't really know, but I think the Beatles are good, but do I want to listen to them like all the time? Not really. That's just my, you know, personal thing, so. E-check. Yeah, let me know about that, Abrosi and other people, because I won't see the, I know someone did this the other day. I won't see like donations and stuff if you send it like an e-check or whatever. I don't really know how that works or why it does that. I couldn't really tell you. I don't know enough about PayPal. But let me know and I will thank you. So thank you, Brosie. Thank you. Someone else did that recently. Let me check. Ugh, dying. I think Entrees Mort did that recently, and I didn't see that they did. Hendrix heavy metal. Yeah, I mean, I'm always up for reading chat. I know sometimes, like, we're like, I'll stream Vesperia, like, I'll be down to read chat, but people don't really, are not huge on Vesperia. So, there won't be that many people chatting, so it's like, well, I'm reading the chat and talking, but I can only hold conversation with like, one person every 5 minutes versus like, people constantly chatting. It's a bit harder to hold a conversation, I don't know. I mean, I guess that's part of life, but I guess it's like a weird kind of catch 22 thing where it's like, as I'm streaming an RPG, it's easier to focus on chat, but it's also like, there's not as much chat going on. So, maybe I could just stream Vesperia. I don't know. I don't know. What the plan is. Alright, later attempt. Lazy dingus. Well, it's all good. I actually had to ask Gray Zod. I think he had a bunch of 3DO games as well. Even then, I already kind of have my mindset of what I want to do for the charity stream, but maybe as. Well, charity stream is like a big deal for a lot of different things, so maybe it'll motivate me to do more stuff in the future. Hello, I love dank memes. What's up, dude? I don't know, I've been kind of a loss to what to stream sometimes, or I'm really into Vesperia right now, so it's like I've been enjoying that quite a bit. You play all the CD games. Yeah, I know people are like talking about the fucking golf game, which I did, I think, the last charity stream, and it's something. It's painful though, because it's like a fucking bullshit timing that makes no sense. Like, there's no way you'd actually be able to figure out on your own without using a guide or just kind of getting lucky. It's so weird. I don't even know how to describe it. It's like a weird animation. Why is this thing like fucking. Oh, this version of this song is awful, dude. Like, it sounds good, but it just keeps getting, like fucking pops every second. Also, thanks for the follows today, guys. Appreciate it. Setsuna. Yeah, I hear Setsuna is really good. I had to look into that. Am I watching porn? No. I wish. Yes, time. The fuck. Why does all this shit have like fucking awful audio, dude? I don't get it. Let's go back to Muggle Village. I did more Vita videos. I don't know. When I feel like spending fucking $30 on burritos, I guess. I've already eaten the pizza though, so I'm just kind of full now. Just chatting away. Looks like I have a double chin because I'm like leaning down. Like fucking Ethan. I don't even know what the fucking faith Ethan makes. It's just so stupid. It's hilarious. You look fucking gay. Wow, dude. The insults are real, dude. And that was good. Lola Bunny? I don't know about that, dude. I'm all about that Vape Nation, son.
Yeah.
That's all that I'm about. Is this FTL music? No, this is Monster Hunter Tri Ultimate. Vape Nation store? I mean, yeah, I mean, people sell vape stuff. I don't know why you act like it's so surprising. I saw Ela actually commented on one of my friends. She was wearing a fucking Ethan shirt that when he had, he's now he's wearing that beanie. He has like that fucking stupid ass face. Like I don't know what face that is. She actually commented on that. It was funny. I was like, oh, is she actually a follower? Like, I don't know. H3H3 Reddit? I don't know. Maybe. I don't really use Reddit, so I couldn't tell you. Current Nation, what the fuck? I don't know, when, yeah, I don't know about that. Miko, the Nico. Miko needs not cat. But, yeah, I don't know if there's any stores I've been to called Vape Nation, but there was like a vape shop at the, when we went to too many games, there was like a little vape booth. It was pretty funny. A grade A asshole. Not to be confused with grade A under A. The vape booth. The vape booth, I don't know. It kind of did. I don't know, cats. Like, fucking, it was weird. I don't know. It was there. It was something. I memed in front of it with Gil, who does actually vape. I don't know. I guess they were kind of, like, trying to get into that, like, I think you can kind of squeeze in a few things, right? Because you can kind of meme in there. Like, you can like, cash in on the meme, right? The Vape Nation meme. But you can also, like, cash in on people maybe, like, wanting to not smoke or whatever. Because, obviously, you can't, like, smoke inside the facility. I don't think you can either. I don't think you can vape in the facility either. But at least it'll be like, oh, well, you know. These are fucking gamers. They vape. Like, there's a lot of streamers that, like, vape, like, on stream. So, I don't know. I mean, there is a market for the vape in the fucking gamer community, I would think. But, I don't know. Did it, you know, how was their business? Who knows? It might have been actually pretty good. Yeah, they like to vape while they play. You know, you got, like, vape and vape in one hand, the control in the other, dude. I don't know. I think it, you know, it was kind of a weird thing to see. But I think that they had, like, a legitimate, like, business opportunity there. Maybe more so than some of the other opportunities, because, like, where's the competition? Like, there's not, like, Rolto Vape Boost. Like, they are, like, the Vape Nation, like, Vape Central. Well, like a lot of other booths, like, well, we have like a bunch of like retro games and shit, and there's like 30 other booths that have the same retro games, or you know, a lot of different art booths, which are cool, but you know, not everyone. I don't know. I guess you know, there's art for everyone, but you know, it's a weird, I guess, commodity. I don't really know what you want to call it, but I think it was weird to have it there, but it actually, I think, probably worked out pretty well for them in the end. And if anything, I don't know. It was interesting. Oh, yeah, if anything, like, I think they were good for just advertising their business, like, on a locale, you know? It's like, well, if you like our vape stuff, you can, like, you know, come to our store, order online, or whatever, blah, 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 et cetera, and so forth. So, like, that's always, like, a cool thing, you know? I don't know, dude. Fucking Vape Nation, dude. Yeah, that's awful. Smoking since you're 13. It's so bad, dude. And that's why I think when people like make fun of the vape because it's a meme, but like in reality, like if you vape because you don't want to smoke, like that's fine. Like there's nothing wrong with that. It's definitely a decent alternative. Not the best alternative, it should be not doing anything, but you know, it's a lot better. Anyways, let's see here. The vape Hillary thing. Yeah, that wasn't. He mentioned that wasn't a political statement. It was just for goofs and gaffs. All right, later, saucepan. I'll see you later, dude. Smoking weed is the best. Yeah, sure, why not, dude? Go green, man. Well, I mean, like, I guess not really commodity. Like, I guess if you're going somewhere, like, you know, in general, I guess if you do something quite often, like eating or drinking or vaping or smoking, like it's nice to have like somewhere you can like, oh, you know, here's extra vape juice or whatever, or here's extra cigarettes or here's extra food or drinks. Like, you're more likely to buy that at a convention than you are like, oh, well, this art's cool, but it's not like a necessity. Not that vaping or smoking is a necessity, but oftentimes people see it as like a secondary necessity. So I don't know. Smoking while refilling the car? Yeah. That's not ever a good thing. CO2 and tar? Yeah, dude. You gotta make a parking lot for your lungs. Fuck, man. I look for it. I have to just look up three ultimate. Oh, it's getting hot in here. Better take off these sunglasses. That's good, Geek Man. Bro, in Overwatch, yeah. I don't know, I play. I can't Overwatch has drained me from liking Overwatch to some extent. Like, I don't want to play as much anymore. Anna, I don't know how she fits in the meta. Like, she seems really good, but then, like, there's people who play Anna that are really fucking bad with Anna. So they don't heal at all. They don't use the nano thing on the right people. Chub and Tuck? What is even a Chub and Tuck? Like, is there any kind of schedule? I believe there is. I think it's been adjusted a few times because of just schedule issues, conflicts. So, like, I know KY, I think, is working that day, but he's going to be like, he changed the schedule so it can work. Let me see here. Okay, I think this is the schedule as of right now. Please, Lisa? No. I watched KY and Dire stream it. It looks pretty good. But since I watched them stream it, I don't really have much reason to play it myself. Yeah, I don't know for it, like, I think there's a lot of scientific stuff you need to read before you just like kind of give into like the political, oh, shit's bad for you. And in reality, it's like the only reason they're saying it's bad for you because they want to fucking have an economical market of and have control over a lot of shit. But anyways, I'd rather not talk about drug wars and stupid shit like that. Listen, Jet Set Radio and play Lucio. Yeah, that's one way to do it. Is there anything really bad about marijuana? Not that I know of. In general, there only seems to be currently good things about it. But I don't know. I mean, obviously, you can choose to use it or not. Just saying, like, oh, you know, shit kills brain cells and stuff. Like, you need to, like, actually know. But, anyways, again, I'd rather not talk about, you know, what's good or bad and that kind of subject. Like, you don't really hear any, like, people dying from overdosing on marijuana or any of that stupid shit. There's a lot of people who overdose on other shit, which happens quite often. Sadly, I've known a few people who have overdosed on various drugs, whether legal or non-legal, so. But yeah, so like some people will play Anna, right? They'll give like the fucking nano boost to like another support or something stupid. It's like, dude, why aren't you giving the nano boost to like someone who actually can do something with it? Like, fucking Reinhardt goes ham with nano boost. Like, Genji with his ult goes ham with nano boost. Like, a lot of people who can like get like who are slow but can do a lot of damage can get in and like do a lot with nano boost. Like, move in, do more damage, do damage faster, things like that, so. Nano boost Symmetra shield? I know nothing about Symmetra. invincible. Yeah. I don't know. Mana Boost is really good, but if you put it on the wrong person, it doesn't really do you any good. Just like, it's like having like a Zyra or whatever her name is, like, if she ults one person, and it sucks because it's like, well, if you ult like 5-man people, then it's good. But then it's like, if you do it like when no one's around to actually do any damage, it doesn't do much good either. Or if you die like immediately after. Like, that's why anytime I'm playing with Zyra, it's like, I tell him, like, here, my ult is fucking ready. Can you tell me when your ult is ready? So when you ult people, I can fucking fall off and do, like, a combo. Like, Hanzo and Zyra ult are fucking disgusting together. Because, like, Zyra ults, they're all stuck in there, and it's like, whatever. And then, like, fucking dragons come and kill them all easy. Like, a lot of times when you use Hanzo's ult, like, people just run away from it, and you don't kill anyone. Lifesite my rip always raised? I don't know, maybe, I guess. I never really noticed that. Might be because, like, my head's at an angle. I guess it is. I don't know. It's weird. Can we stop talking about weed? Thank you. Can you post Vine Brew links in the chat? Yeah, that's fine. You missed the food, unfortunately, basically me. I'm done eating, we're just kind of discussing things, but then chat's kind of dissolving into stupidity at the moment, so would prefer if people... I know that there's like a thing, I just don't remember it right now. This is like 30 minutes long. If I switch the topic to Overwatch and people are still talking about stuff, I would rather than not. And I'm sure there's people that are just trolling because they're like, oh. Do I play Pokemon Go? Yeah, I do a little bit. I have not streamed Bloodborne yet, Linear Regression. Right now, so I'm kind of at like a weird point in Dark Souls 3. Like, I wanted to do like, get all the achievements, right? But, like, I'm looking at my list here, right? So what I need left in Dark Souls 3? Stranger Things? I don't think I've heard of that, Oisu. I need Watch Dogs of Faerun, rank 2. I need the Skull Ring from Ludith of Cortland, so I need to kill him. I need the Proper Bow, which is, I guess, from a side quest I have to do next game, or next playthrough. I need a Great Deep Soul from Aldrich Faithful, which I think I'm, like, really close. Oh, no, Aldrich Faithful, I still need a bunch of things for them. But it's only rank 1, so I can live with that. Warmth from the Mound Makers, I don't know what rank I need from... to get that. Let's see here. That is rank 2, which sucks. I don't even know anything about the Mound Makers. Great Lightning Spear. Warrior Sunlight rank 2. Dark Moon Blade rank 2. Dark Moon Blade, I think I need 12 more, which is painful. Oh, just like a lot of PvP grinding, which a lot of it's not even really viable, so... Nice. Zengoose. Do I have a YouTube? I do, actually. I'm trying to use my YouTube more. So, again, if you guys have suggestions or other things or want to help promote my YouTube, please do. I would appreciate that. So, the first YouTube link is my main YouTube where I do, like, highlights and other stupid shit. The other YouTube is my VODs, which is kind of a mess right now, so I'll fix that up one of these days, but I'm just trying to catch up. When is the charity stream? It is on the 23rd. So in about 2 days, so it's on Saturday. I guess technically it goes to Saturday to Sunday. I don't know if if anyone's doing anything after my block because I'm the closer. I'll have to ask. Dark Souls 2? Oh, fuck that, dude. Yeah, well, the problem is there's a lot of things that are broken in Dark Souls 3. So, like, Dark Moon Covenant, like, the summon time for that is, like, hours. No games? I don't know. Maybe. I might do some Monster Hunter. We'll see. Well, it's kind of like the difficulty forte and kind of being able to build your character the way you want to or in various ways, which is pretty cool. So it's not just like one static build that's like the best for everything, you know? Dark Souls is not that hard. I think the biggest thing about Dark Souls that makes it difficult is kind of the learning curve. But even then, a lot of times it can be learning the boss or whatever it is. But most importantly is kind of learning what like the ideal weapon is. And what else? I guess like the stat scaling and things like that, knowing how that all works. Because I know like when I first did my playthrough, I had like a ton of strength, but I wasn't using a weapon that actually benefited from strength. Or I didn't really know how the upgrade system works. So it's a bit about learning how the system works. And when you do, it's fairly easy. Did you want to do some Monster Hunter Dire? Where's the food? I ate it, Queen. Well, there's some left here, but I'm full. There's my left of my pizza there. I need to bring it upstairs. But no, it's a pretty fun game. I enjoy it quite a bit. And like the difficulty, like there's still difficulty in the bosses and stuff. I don't think it's as hard as it used to be kind of labeled as, but still pretty good. But maybe when I'm done with maybe when I'm done with Dark Souls 3, I'll probably hit a Bloodborne at some point, but I'm not sure when. There's a few other games I kind of want to stream and as like an interval to Dark Souls and Tales. I haven't really figured those out yet. I still need to finish Fire Emblem, but I don't know. I guess my motivation to finish Fire Emblem is tough because a lot of times I'll play it and I'm just like constantly backseat gaming, and it's fucking annoying. From people who are usually pretty cool too, so it's like, what is your fucking deal? Someone asked about Juggalo Face. How much would the charity need to raise? I don't know, dude. Again, that would probably come out of my pocket finding the face paint, which wouldn't be hard, but I don't think I'd prefer to make myself look like an idiot. Even for charity. Like, at least if I'm gonna do something for charity, at least it should be something reasonable. I mean, it's funny, it's fine, but I don't know. Isn't Twitch chat always backseat gaming? Well, to some extent, but like with Dark Souls, there isn't really much backseat gaming, because I know like how to build and stuff, and there's no like absolute build again. Like when it comes to Fire Emblem, like everyone's like, oh, you should use like all these characters, and you should only do what I said that this should be done. Why are you so bad, dude? Why are you fucking not beating everything in the first try instantly by not knowing that there's fucking traps and more guys spawning like in a position? Because like that's what happens a lot in Fire Emblem. Like you'll clear out like a bunch of guys, and then you'll get into like a position. It's like, oh, okay, I'm doing well right now. And then like a bunch of guys will like spawn from the behind and like, oh well, fuck. Yeah, maybe you should level up some more. Like in Fire Emblem, fucking Conquest, you can't grind. There's no, it's not like Awakening and Birthright where you can kind of go back and forth in areas and like fight various things. You cannot grind in Birthright unless you buy the DLC, which, you know, I'm not fucking buying the DLC. So, yeah, it's pretty dumb how people are just constantly criticizing. It's like, why aren't you playing on classic mode, you fucking pussy? It's like, 'cause I don't want to like reset every 5 minutes on my stream. Afrika TV, yeah, there's mukbangs on Afrika mounted Dot Man. I know. I don't know. I guess Afrika is more well known for StarCraft and GSL and stuff, but the Afrika Freaks. What a fucking stupid name. That sounds like a high school name or something for like a team. Are there any microtransactions in Pokemon Go? There are plenty of microtransactions in Pokemon Go. I know there's always backseat gamers in chat, but with Fire Emblem, it's like especially prevalent, and it's especially annoying too. People have to tell you like every like fucking micromanage every move you do. It's like imagine it playing chess and someone's like breathing on your neck, like telling you where to go, after the fact that you already went there. So it's like, oh, you should have moved your pawn up there, dude. What's your problem? You're so fucking bad at chess. But soda, I don't drink soda mostly. I was drinking lemonade, which I still have some. I try to avoid drinking soda because it's not ideal. There is an American site for Frika. I didn't know that, or English site, sorry. American site. Dual SIM on Afrika. If there's an English one, that'd be interesting. I don't know how that would work. I thought Afrika was exclusively English. See, I think with the mukbangs for them, it's more about like eating a lot of food, which I'm down to do, but like, I don't know. Most of the time, I don't have the, I don't get insane donations like the mukbangers on Afrika, so I can't afford to buy like, a fucking gourmet meal like they do. Oh, okay. Well, it's just kind of like neat to go outside and catch Pokemon in real life, Forte. Like it's kind of like the old nerd's dream. Other than that, it's not like anything super spectacular. But then again, I don't think it really was meant to like replace the main games at the same time, Forte. It wasn't like, oh, Pokemon Go is gonna replace like, Sun and Moon when Sun and Moon's been announced and is like hyped right now, so. Even though a lot of the Pokemon in Sun and Moon look kind of dumb, to be honest with you. I know people are like, oh, what the fuck? How can you not like this Pokemon? I'm like, the Pokemon is literally a wreath of flowers. Like, what? There's always dumb Pokemon in every generation. As much as I love Pokemon, it's just a realistic reality of the situation. If they have real Pokemon combat, I like to think that they're gonna be able to let you transfer them when Sun and Moon comes out, but I don't know. What's my point? On what? Muck is sludge. I like Muck though. The living garbage bag, yeah. That one was interesting. I mean, there's still a delay on Twitch mounted Datman. I think it's a lot less than used to be. I know there was like a beta thing I opted in for like a long time ago, but I don't know what the actual delay is at the moment. Yeah. Great ideas. Well, I'm saying, like, Nefkin, like, that Pokemon Go is fine for what it is. That's my point. I think it's fine. Here for pizza? You missed it, Pumpkin Sweet Tea. Sorry. Well, pizza's still there. I'm just not going to eat the rest of it. How much do I usually make here? Like, income wise? I don't know. I mean, I don't really get a lot of donations if that's what you're asking. I mean, social eating is still fairly new, mounted Ant-Man. And I think maybe every social eating stream I might get like $5, if even that. But it's not like enough to really live a lot off of. I mean, that's pays for most of my food, but that doesn't cover all expenses. I mean, most streamers live off their subscriber money anyways, but yeah. I don't know, I guess if you really focused on social eating and made that like your full-time thing, you probably could make a lot of money, but I don't know. Yeah, and even then for me, like, eating, like, I'll eat like maybe 20, 30 minutes and then I'll spend like an hour or two or three just fucking talking, so. But, yeah, anyways, when it comes to Pokemon Go, I think it's fine for what it is. It's not meant to, like, it's not meant to replace the main game series, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. I don't want it to. That would require me actually getting up and catching Pokemon, which I don't want to do. It's fine if I'm, like, out and about, but I don't want to go out of my way to fucking catch Pokemon. Well, I don't know. I can't really say much about the anime. I mean, it's, what, like, pretty old now, and it's like whatever. Master Chieftain confirmed for being a cat. He's gonna eat cat food on stream. You heard it here first. He's an echo. Yeah, Bunga Sweet Tea, I kind of mentioned it earlier where people were just doing stupid shit. Like I said, I was driving through Old Town and, like, I can't see people. Like, the Old Town is not well lighted. So when I'm driving through, like, I'm almost hitting people because people are, like, walking all over the place not paying attention. So it's like, what the fuck, dude? Watch where you're going, you fool!
Ah. Shit. I don't know. I just don't know how people can be so oblivious. Pains me. The crazy guy in courage, yeah. Yeah, I don't understand like the whole thing where people like post videos when they're driving. Like if someone else is holding the camera and they're like doing the videos while they're driving, all right, fine, sure, whatever. At least you're focusing on the road, even if you're making commentary. But like, well, you're making videos while you're driving, that's fucking stupid. What's up, buck sauce? Finish the pizza? I'm not gonna finish the pizza. I'm full, dude. I mean, I think it's fine for people going outside and all that shit. Pumpkin sweet tea, like, it's good for people to actually get out of the house and do shit, like, walk around. But at the same time, common sense is not something that always happens, sadly. So, it's like, yeah, I don't know, dude. All right, I'll put the pizza slice through the USB, and then you'll be all good to go. What's up, Cruise Man?
Alright, let me put this pizza away and then we'll do some video games of some kind, some Monster Hunter or something. Forgot all these songs are like 30 minutes long. Just a pepperoni with beef. New Berserk anime. I've heard mixed things on it, so I couldn't tell you. I remember watching some Berserk movie, and then I don't think I ever finished it or something like that. I don't know. But yeah, for all those people coming from social eating, yeah, if you want to follow, I appreciate it. I do social eating every once in a while. And it usually ends up turning like this, where I'll just kind of eat for a little bit and then just kind of chat with the chat. There's the pizza. Has no nips and it's CGI. Okay, I don't know. I don't really know much about Berserk. So I couldn't tell you. I think the next thing I'm looking at right now for watching would be the, whatever that one anime, the other one that One Punch Man made, like the something, the OPM, the MPO or something, I don't know. Looks like I'm just in time to play some Monster Hunter with Dire 2, so I'll be right back.
back.
I blame Apple. Love Cycle looks good.
Yeah, buddy. Love that. Oh, yeah. Oof.
Alright. I just finished eating, so sorry. I mean, I finished eating like a while ago, but I just put all my shit away. So we're gonna switch over to Monster Hunter. And now people are coming like an hour or two later. Like, it doesn't take me that long to eat a pizza, dude.
Like, it can, but usually not.
Hold on. Alright, so, yeah, I already ate the food, dude. I'm switching up now. Am I here? Well, I'm about to switch, so. I heard there's a thing called time, and it takes time to do things sometimes. When you have to do things like switch your game. It's a pretty cool concept. I don't know, I think most of the Monster Hunter games are pretty fun. So, if you like Monster Hunter in general, it probably is worth it to you if you have friends to play with. If you're playing alone, it's usually not as fun. But anyways, for those who came for social eating and are leaving, thank you for watching, thank you for stopping by. Feel free to follow. I stream video games as well. Obviously being on Twitch, but if you want, I will do more social eating streams in the future, but we'll see. Anyways, I'll see you guys in a bit. Let me reset the stream for Monster Hunter. Peace.